Hello and welcome to Produplification. If like me, you spent a lot of time in Google Apps Script to automate all of your tasks, you must also add a lot of buttons directly in your Google Sheet file in order to trigger all of those functions that you create. If you have a small file with just a few functions, this is still quite okay, since you only have a few buttons to be added to your spreadsheet. But if you get a file that is bigger and bigger with more and more functions, so more and more buttons, this can quickly become quite messy, and at the end, this can even look not so professional anymore. So today, what we are going to do is just to learn how to add a custom menu in Google Sheet, just next to the other standard menus, and where you will be able to store all the buttons to trigger all of your functions in a much more structured way and also better looking way compared to a series of buttons that you would simply add to your spreadsheet. So now, what we can do is directly go to Google Apps Script by simply clicking on the Extensions menu and by selecting Apps Script. As you can see, this is opening a new window for Google Apps Script, and as you can also see there, there is already a function that I've actually prepared before the video and that will simply allow us to format the selected cell with a specific color and a specific border. And now, all the purpose of this video will simply be to create a new menu in our Google Sheet file and to simply link this menu with our function color cell in order to directly trigger this latest. Now, the first step to create this new menu in our Google Sheet file is actually to create a new function in Google Apps Script that will be in charge of creating this new menu. So for now, we simply call it create menu and we put it just above the previous function. And now, within this new function, the first thing that we need to do is to create a new variable or an instance that will simply allow us to directly interact with the user interface. This can allow us to create a menu like what we are going to do, but this could also allow us to do multiple things that we will not see today, like for example, open a dialog box, etc., etc. So for that, we create a new variable as usual. We call it simply user interface. And then we call the spreadsheet app dot get UI function. UI, which simply means user interface, and as I explained to you, which will allow us to create this instance to the user interface. Then, thanks to this new variable, we are directly able to create our new menu. So for that, we start from this variable and we simply apply the create menu function to it, as you guess, to create our menu. And we also need to provide one input parameter to this function. And this parameter that we will provide between quotes, this is simply the name that we want to give to this new menu and that will be displayed in our Google Sheet file. So in our case, we'll simply call it highlight cell. Okay, so now we have our menu and what we can do next is just add a new item to this menu with the trigger or the button to our function. So for that, we apply the add item function to this menu that will simply allow us to add a new item to the menu with two input parameters that we will provide to it. The first of those two parameters will simply be the name that we want to give to this new item that we provide between quotes as usual. And in this case, we'll call it simply important cell. And the second of the two input parameters that we also provide between quotes will simply be the name of the function that we want to trigger with this new item. So in our case, we want to trigger the function that is just below and that is called colorCell. So until now, we have created our menu with the item to trigger our function, but so far, it can actually not be visible in our Google Sheet file because it's not yet integrated in the user interface. So finally, the last function that we need to apply to the whole group that we have just created is the hat2UI, which will simply allow us to hat the whole menu that we have just created to the user interface and make it visible in our file. Okay, so now our function is completed, and what we need to do as well is to set up this function to trigger itself when we open our Google Sheet file in order to create our menu and to make it visible in Google Sheet. So for that, we are going to use a specific function which is called a trigger function and which will be named after a specific name that we will be able to find in the documentation from Google. So we can directly go to the specific page that we are looking for in this documentation, and there we can directly find the list of all those trigger functions that are predefined by Google. So the one that we are looking for is simply the first one, which is called onOpen. And as you can read there, it will simply allow to directly trigger a function when we open the spreadsheet. So if we go back to Google Apps Script, the only thing that we need to do is to replace the name of our function, so create menu, by this new name onOpen, and by doing so with this specific name, Google Apps Script will automatically know that these functions need to be triggered when you will open your Google Sheet file, and therefore it will directly trigger your menu that you will be able to use directly in your file. Okay, so now almost everything is set up properly, but there is just a small typo that I have just noticed, and which is simply the second S of spreadsheet app that needs to be a lowercase instead of an uppercase. So now that this is corrected, we can save again the function. We can close Google Apps Script as well as our Google Sheet file, and we can open again our Google Sheet file to check that our menu is well created in our Google Sheet. Okay, this takes a few seconds, but now as you can see, we have an additional menu that have been created, and if we select this menu and we click on the first item that is called important cell and that we have created in our function, as you can see, this triggers our function and this format our selected cell. And after that, what you may also want to do is simply add some additional items to your new menu. So this is of course feasible as well. We just go back to Google Apps Script, and there we will simply add a new function that will be almost identical to the colorCell function. So we call it simply colorCell2, and we'll set up a green background instead of the blue background. And now that we have this new function that we also want to integrate to our menu, the only thing that we need to do is just add an additional item to this menu, thanks again to the addItem function that we will implement just after the previous one. So of course, for this new addItem function, we'll need to change the name of the function to colorCell2 instead of just colorCell. And what we also need to do is change the name that we want to give to this new item and that we want to display in Google Sheet. So for example, this one, we'll call it simply more important cell. Once this is done, we just save the project and we close everything again. And we reopen again the add menu Google Sheet file to check that our menu is again properly created. So as you can see, we still have our menu highlight cell, which is there at the top. And if we click on it this time, you see that we have our additional item, which is called more important cell, that has been created. And if we click on it, we trigger the second function, which allows us to put a green background on the selected cell. So that's it for today. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and that you are now able to create a menu with all your triggers to your functions instead of a bunch of buttons all over the place on your spreadsheet. Thanks a lot for watching and see you soon.